Welcome to English Worship for everybody. Today is June 13, 2021. Today's scripture is from 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 13 through 17. Let Christ rule how you live. Let's see today's basic Christian training. Jesus perfectly solved our problems of sin by dying on the cross and rising again from the dead for us. However, our sins are not automatically forgiven. How can our sins be forgiven? First, you must repent wholeheartedly. Scripture says, Peter replied, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you'll receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." In order for you to believe Jesus as your personal Savior and Lord, you should repent your sins. Repentance is to turn from the way you are forth. You must realize how your life was sinful and mourn wholeheartedly and turn to the Lord volitionally in your intention. Are you willing to repent the sins you have committed? Okay, let's continue to pray for the people in the world, persecuted church worldwide. Number one, North Korea. Number two, Afghanistan. Number three, Somalia. And also unreached people groups. First, India, Pakistan, China, and Bangladesh. As you see, the key trends of 2021, COVID-19 is used as a weapon by persecutors. Open Doors research reveals the extent to which Christians are being specifically excluded from receiving COVID-19 aid. Incidents have been recorded across Asia and Africa, where vulnerable believers are deliberately neglected by local authorities when food is distributed. Christian nurses are denied by vital PPE, and some Christians are even baselessly blamed for the spread of the virus. As you see in the picture, Joshua Project provides unreached people groups, country size proportional to UPZ population. Let's pray for the persecuted countries and also unreached people groups in the world. O Lord, we pray and bless these places and countries. Shine your light upon these countries where darkness is rampant and spread. Lord, have mercy on the people in the land. Even though COVID-19 is not the good way and they are used as to persecute them. Father God, we believe that you are watching over every situation and circumstances, Lord, and bring your peace upon this land. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's continue to pray for situations in India. Still, COVID-19 is growing and wreak havoc on the societies in India, and also pray for peace in America, where anti-Asian crimes are arousing, and also Middle East, between the conflict between Israel and the Palestine, and also for political stability in Myanmar. As you see the picture, the situations in India and also the bombing in Israel and Palestine and anti-hate crime, anti-Asian crime in America, and situation in Myanmar. Let's pray. Oh God, there are unimaginable tragedy and sadness is going on in the part of the world. Lord, have mercy on them. More than anything else, your revival, your fire from above on this land and these places, on these peoples, Lord, so that they can see the light of the Lord and see the salvation coming into their lives. Father God, we ask your holiness and your transformation on India and America, Myanmar and the Middle East. Lord, have mercy on them and many other parts of the world that are gripped by sadness and grief. Lord, pour your spirit upon this land so all of us can experience this global spiritual awakening and revival in this last time of your time. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen. And also pray for the carbon crisis, climate crisis, carbon reducing. I recommend strongly to see this Netflix documentary called Seaspiracy. And also, let's pray for your church and your community and your family. For this week, we have this small activity to find any product that is not plastic. We can see this corrugated earphone and wooden toothbrush. If you find them and share that on your SNS, let's pray. Father God, I don't know how many people are watching this and having this worship together. Even so, Father God, I'd like to share that your presence is penetrating into the hearts of people who are joining this worship service. And let us pray for this Carbon Fast campaign and also pray for our church and family to join in for this global spiritual awakening. So we can come back to the Lord. We can come and confess our sins and repent before God, Almighty God. Father God, have mercy on the people in the world so that they can see the light of you. We will also pray for any urgent prayer request of people near and far and countries who needs our help, needs our prayer desperately at this moment of day and year and week. I don't know every request that is urgent, but Lord, we pray for them and they can find the light. Thank you, Lord. Pour your presence and your grace upon them. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Okay. Let's go ahead and read today's scripture. It's from 1 Peter chapter 3, 13 and 17. If you always try to do good things, then nobody should hurt you. But somebody might give you trouble even when you do what is right. If that happens, God will bless you. So do not be afraid of what people may do to you. Do not worry about it. Instead, always remember that Christ is your Lord. Let him rule how you live. People may ask you, why do you trust God to help you? You must always be ready to answer them about that. 16. But when you tell them, be kind and polite, do only what you know is right. Then those people will see that you live in a good way because you believe in Christ. When they say bad things against you, they will become ashamed. 17. Sometimes God may let you have trouble and pain, even when you have done good things. But that is better than if you have trouble and pain because you have done bad things. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. Even I read this scripture, this verse 17 touches my heart. Many people will say, I didn't do anything bad. Why this pandemic is going on? Many people lost their lives, even our brothers and sisters in our mission field. This scripture gives us the answer. That is better than if you have trouble and pain because you have done bad things. Come back to the verse 13. I put the good things. What kind of good things do we do? Today's passage is keep repeating the expression good things. Good things. The verse says, 13 says always. It mentions always. Before I put my eyes on this verse, this one word, which is always, I thought I'm good. In this respect, I can confidently confess that I'm a total sinner. Yes, I cannot be always kind, always do good things, so I'm a total sinner. Verse 14, care only about whether you do what is right. From this verse, I can clearly see that I don't need to be influenced by what others may do to me, since God is watching over me. In a nutshell, in summary, God is encouraging us to do what is right, and do not be afraid of what would happen to us. Verse 15, confidently ready. From this verse, I can ask, who is your Lord and who is your master in your life? Many times I ask myself and also wondering whether who is my master, who has the control of my life. I hope you can ask this question to you today. Who is your Lord? Who is your master? Who has the control of your life? As you believe in Jesus Christ, some Christians tend to confine Jesus only in a church. When they go outside, or when they leave during the week, nobody can find any difference between them and others. Even though they say they're Christian, they're followers of Jesus Christ, but nobody can distinguish them from non-believers. So, who decides how you live? Maybe your interest, maybe your happiness, maybe your delight decides how you live? Or Lord, our Savior, decides how you live? This is a significant question. I want you to ask this question one more time. Who decides how you live? If you give your life fully to God, then you stay confident in your faith and always ready to tell people why you trust God. Verse 16, do the right thing as much as you know. This verse continues to mention the relationship between our conduct and our faith. Our belief and our behavior, there's a strong connection. That's what this verse is all about. Kind and polite way of speaking is based on keeping our temper down. Your belief will be revealed through your casual words and actions. When you worship, when you meet Christians, your words and your actions are just fine. But when you get out of your Christian setting, then how do you say and how do you act? That is real you. That is your faith. Verse 17. Don't lose heart even when trouble or pain comes upon you. The passage continues to mention our doing good things. Our identity, as you can see in 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9, will transform us to live a victorious life in the face of suffering and respect people in authority. Not only that, that moves us to pursue a right relationship with people, and we can overcome sufferings when we realize our true identity in the Lord. Our life is not for proving what we are in the world, but for revealing who we are in Christ. The fear of the Lord conquers every other fear. So what can we apply from today's message? Keep our conscience clear through obedience. Also, as today's title says, let Christ rule how you live. Conscience may be compared to a window that lets in the light of God's truth. If we persist in disobeying, the window gets dirtier and dirtier until the light cannot enter. This leads to a defiled conscience. A seared conscience is one that has been so sinned against that it no longer is sensitive to what is right and wrong. It is even possible for the conscience to be so poisoned that it approves things that are bad and also accuses when the person does good. This the Bible calls an evil conscience. Now look into your conscience and search your heart while you still have a chance. We still have chance. Don't lose your chance. Open Doors Prayer for the Persecuted. Today's title is Life-Giving Message. Despite the coronavirus global pandemic and border cross closings, Open Doors has continued our critical radio ministry in North Korea. As sermons, Christian stories, testimonies, and praise songs are broadcast, underground believers regularly receive Christian lessons and encouragement. They hide in secret places and listen to the radio programs. Sometimes they take turns listening and then share what they've heard and learned with their fellow underground Christians. Thank God that His word does not return void, and pray that secret believers will be fortified and lifted up by what they hear. As you see, there are secret believers in the north and also many parts of the persecuted countries, including Afghanistan, Somalia, Libya, Pakistan, Eritrea, Yemen, Iran, and many others. Let's pray for them and bless them, and we can be strengthened also in faith. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. And also remember that who rules how we live today. Let's pray. O God, your salvation, your presence is the only way that can we survive today. We can stay alive today, Lord, not because we are not with the COVID-19 or any other disease, but because your presence, but because of your grace, we are alive. Father God, let us remember that we have still have chance to repent and confess our sins so that we can bring this spiritual revival awakening to our family, church, and country, our neighbors far and near and far. Father God, have mercy on this situation that we are going through. Lord, let us take it seriously so that we can go to the Lord in prayer and ask your mercy. Ask your mercy. Lord, there is no way, no other way, no other, no detour. Only you are the way that we can walk. Please open our eyes to see this dire situation, desperate situation, that we can turn to you. Only you are the last resort and only resort we can turn to. Lord, brought down, bring down your salvation and your revival. Lord, raise up prayer warriors and gather and pray continuously and together, O God. And also pray, we're praying for the secret believers in the North Korea and other countries. Lord, strengthen them and let them experience your grace, whatever circumstances they may be in, Lord. And also likewise, we come back to the Lord and pray and bless the people who are not in the light of the Lord, not in the salvation of the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, everyone, for joining today's worship service. With that, we wrap up today's worship service, and I pray that you can walk in the Spirit-filled week and be in the presence of the Lord. And hope to see you again next week. Thank you.